people are quitting concepts like pornography completely. People are embracing concepts like celibacy. There is something called the NoFap movement. So, sir, can you explain the role of celibacy in spiritual growth as well as mental growth? Like, what does it do for a human being's mind?
देखिए, पहली चीज celibacy का सबसे बड़ा फायदा क्या है? आपका focus बहुत amazing हो जाता है. You attraction to distraction is over. So, what happens is, जब आपका focus बहुत भयंकर है, तो आप उसको disturb नहीं कर सकता.
You will experience like better physical health, yeah. Your energy will improve and your mental clarity will improve.
Whatever profession you are in, right? Whether it's a corporate world, whether it's a creative world, or it can be as simple as being confident in front of people. It's unreal. I mean, you have to practice to experience it. I'm not even saying years, right? Just do it for 21 days and and see how you feel about it.
Celibacy has its own benefits. It is its own charm, it has own energy level, definitely it has.
Celibacy ke na do fayde hain, material level pe bhi fayda hai, which is physical level, aur spiritual level pe to fayda hai hi aapko bahut bada.
So, there was this research done by like three scientists and they just wanted to see like what semen constitutes. They found that 90% of it was water and 10% of it was nutrients. And those were the nutrients which included most of the minerals, cholesterol and other minerals which are foods for the brain.
Like, matlab, it's basically like you're putting petrol into your brain.
It's how much forward modern science has gone into it. Yeah. But Ayurveda is very clear about the fact that it moves upwards and nourishes your cells, brain, and the overall body.
Yeah. Also, I feel that, again, I keep saying this in a bunch of our podcasts, that there's a whole world of science that the world of science hasn't discovered yet.
What do scientists do? What do you say? Scientists, what?
Research.
Why?
Analyze.
Research is the word, right? Mm. Which means you never say scientists are searching. Mm. Technically, scientists are supposed to search, right?
Got
it. What does research mean? It's already there. Mm. They're researching it.
Yeah.
So what's there 5,000 or how many ever years ago, they are researching it.
Celibacy ka sabse bada strength kya hota hai? Urdhvareti. Your semen has a lot of power, and so much so that you can procreate and recreate a new life. You can give birth to a new child, and if you can actually save your semen and start flowing upwards, according to Ayurveda, start nourishing your brain cells in such a way that you build no dietary amulet can do it, and plus you also build uncommon intelligence and photographic memory.
Even for example, sex for people, they don't do it all the time. I don't think anybody does it all the time. They have, times when they feel the urge in the body. Unfortunately, we think sex is bad. Sex should not be taken as a bad or a sin. In this country, it was not seen as a sin. It's a Western thought we adopted in this country for several centuries now. If you are using your energy into a creative channel, you are putting it into some creativity, or in service, or even in studies, sex is not a botheration at all. Nobody is bothered about sex when they have exams. At those times, they are so busy. And when you have an important mission to accomplish in life, that is not some issue that comes into your head. It's one energy in the body that is either sex energy, or it converts itself into love, compassion, anger also. People who suppress sex, sometimes they become very angry. The same energy gets an outlet in anger. But if the same energy is channeled through meditation as love and compassion, then you see that you are in bliss all time. You should not say this is bad or sin, or I have to get out of it. No, it's a natural instinct. Honor it and then go beyond it.
We live in a society where people chase physical pleasures a lot. The greatest pleasures are mental and spiritual, but not everyone discovers those.
The kind of distractions you have in life to get towards that urge, you know, I mean, all of social media is in today's time super like hypersexual. We live in super and hypersexual times, right? The kind of content there is out there are so many like inclinations for people to just go out and jerk off, you know, and just to satisfy their need. Times of instant gratification. Porn is so easily accessible, man. So once you consciously, you know, let that thought out of your mind that, okay, the goal is always to, you know, just, you know, jerk off. Like, okay, I have one quota a day, I will use it now.
When you keep on masturbating too much, then it's like a compulsion loop. Yeah, even if your body is not looking for it, your mind is just constantly telling you.
Then
there is no difference between a cocaine addict and a masturbation addict.
100%.
Because then it's all about dopamine release only.
Yeah.
When you masturbate like excessively, too much, like almost every day you're doing it 3-4 times, then you do not enjoy the real sex.
But porn also, it gives you a wrong idea of what sex is. Sometimes porn is very violent. It also, there was this concept I read that if you watch a lot of porn, you basically start getting excited about sex as a third person thing. Matlab, because you're watching people having sex on your screen and that's what you're ejaculating to, your brain ka dopamine release gets associated with the third person view. Ki, I'm seeing two people having sex and that's what I'm enjoying. So if you actually end up having sex in real life, then you know you won't enjoy it as much because you'll be like, wait, this is a first person view. It's like playing say Fortnite versus playing, you know, Call of Duty, where it's first person versus third person. Because of masturbating, you get very used to your hand on like a penis. So when you actually go through sex, it feels very different from having that hand on your penis always. So a lot of guys, and I know this from engineering college, a lot of my friends, they could last for very long in bed, like as in they could like, you know, be having sex for very long, but they never ejaculated because they were so used to masturbating. And after having intercourse, then they would go and like masturbate, which is like you're kind of spoiling the vibe for your partner also.
Actually, that's true. Like when you masturbate like excessively, too much, like almost every day you're doing it 3-4 times, then you do not enjoy the real sex. Actually, if you are getting addicted to anything, if that thing is becoming, your life is revolving around masturbation.
Then
you're in a mess, I guess.
Yeah.
If you actually start thinking that, what am I actually feeling? I mean, I'm not saying having sex is wrong or being physical is wrong. No. Why? Why? What is it? And is it with, is it happening with multiple people? What is it that you're feeling good about it? What is it that you're feeling? At the end of the day, why somebody doing that? It's for that point millisecond of ejaculation time, right? After that, you're tired.
Yeah.
And then you don't feel like doing it for some time, and then you get back. Why? Because the body clock also takes some time to assimilate that and bring back that energy or whatever, right?
Yeah.
But for 15 minutes or 10 minutes or whatever it is, I mean, after having a orgasm or after ensuring that ejaculation happens, why are you not feeling it for the next 10 minutes? What's the reason?
NoFap eventually becomes easy. If you practice NoFap, this is what you'll see. Eventually, you'll find it easy to beat your cravings. Initially, it is a little bit difficult.
Absolutely.
So I want to take you back to that 18-year-old version of yourself whose hormones are all over the place. What used to go on in your head, dude, if you saw like an attractive
lady? It is unreal. It's pretty much reverse psychology, right? Or it's nature's wish that it tests your mind power, mental strength. You know, it happens to a lot of you all, I'm sure. You say, aaj se main diet mein hu. You'll get called for 10 weddings. You'll get called for the best birthday parties. You'll get called for best friends this, best friends that. And you're like, abhi aaj se maine, I started my diet today. Kyo aaj? And then, aaj nahi, kal se chalu karo. So you think, acha, kal se main chalu karunga. So then next day you're like, okay, today morning onwards, morning you would have done it.
Yeah.
Afternoon you would have done it. Evening again you'd be like, Ranveer, let's go for a party. And then, you know, because when the moment you tend to take a certain kind of a goal for yourself, the nature's first rule is, how do we tend to break it?
How do we test it?
Test it, stroke, break it, stroke, whatever you want to call it, for the good part. Can this person, he or she, withstand that test?
So if I tell you, don't think about sex, you'll think more about sex. So instead of doing that, have a higher purpose established in mindset.
I think if somebody is like intrigued by NoFap, or for example, if you're someone who is skeptic about NoFap, I would just tell them that you try it for like 1 week, 30 days, or whenever, how much is it possible for you? You just try it. And you will see the benefits coming.
Honestly, I have had phases where I didn't do a 200 days right from the beginning, right? I've had many phases where I've done 10 days, I've done a week, I've done 15 days, moved to a month, did 60 days, broken it, things like that. So my like two cents on that would be, don't push directly for a 200 day goal or a 500 day goal, or say that from today I will just stop it. You know, it may not be entirely possible. Take little steps towards it, and you know, build your willpower towards that. It's like, you know, instead of directly going into a final championship match, play with the rookies first. You know, practice yourself. Go one level up and then go for the finals. So when you consciously stop thinking of it as a part of you, you will not feel those urges very internally. You will, and I'm not saying you will suppress them, you will just not feel them. You will automatically, it'll be second nature for you to drive that urge to something else, to start writing creatively. You will automatically pick up the pen or pick up your laptop and start writing, or pick up the dumbbell, move your energies to something that is more productive to you as a person. So that is what's happening at day 200. You don't consciously think, oh cool, ab jaake we'll have to let one out, ab jaake bathroom mein phone leke lotion leke jana hai. So I think that is the major difference. It makes you way calmer.
100%. So I feel that celibacy combined with the spiritual practices like meditation, like living a clean, ethical life, that is the real key. And that it's not just abstaining from sex or abstaining from masturbation or something.
Yeah. You see, you force abstinence on you, then it comes to you from some other distorted form inside of you. You become irritable, angry, and emotionally imbalanced. Sometimes you're not so clear in your communication, thinking. All these sort of psychological issues will arise out of it.
Yes, sir.
If you want to practice celibacy, you must do yoga and meditation. Then you will see it's not an issue at all. It has become a natural thing for you.
So it's basically for you guys who are just starting out on NoFap. It's a very simple yoga. Suppose you are feeling lust. You're feeling horny, basically. Okay? So you do feel a certain rush of blood going to your sex organs. The yoga is that you just sit in one place, okay, and you take a deep breath in. And keep in mind, a lot of meditation and yoga is a lot of visualization. So you just visualize that all that energy is actually flowing upward to your spine, into your brain. So you breathe in, take it upward into your brain, and then breathe out and imagine that energy spreading through your brain. NoFap is great, celibacy is great, but what happens after marriage when you're supposed to have sex? Are you supposed to not ejaculate there?
Brahmacharya is needed until the age of 25 for sure. जो हमारे शास्त्रों में बताया गया 25 साल की उम्र तक ब्रह्मचर्य का प्रैक्टिस करना बहुत जरूरी है, क्योंकि वहाँ मैं आपको बताऊँ, नो ग्रेटनेस यू कैन एवर बिल्ड वाइल रनिंग बिहाइंड वुमेन एंड सैटिस्फाइंग योर जेनिटल्स. क्योंकि जिसका जेनिटल के सेटिस्फैक्शन की जो डिजायर है उसको कंट्रोल कर लिया ना, तो फिर मेरे ख्याल है आपको बहुत चीजें वैसे भी डिस्ट्रैक्ट नहीं कर सकती, नहीं तो फोकस और एब्जॉर्प्शन नहीं आ सकता आपके गोल स्टेटमेंट में.
सर, एज 25 के बाद क्या होता है, आप ये क्यों कह रहे हो?
उसके बाद फिर गृहस्थ आश्रम है. गृहस्थ आश्रम इज एन ऑप्शन टू कम आउट ऑफ ब्रह्मचारी आश्रम, एंड देयर इज वेयर यू आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू प्रोक्रिएट अ न्यू चाइल्ड. सो देन यू आर नो मोर अ ब्रह्मचारी. यू कैन स्टिल प्रैक्टिस ब्रह्मचर्य इवन इन गृहस्थ लाइफ बाय रेगुलेटिंग योर सेक्सुअल लाइफ. धर्म वृद्धो कामो अस्मि. सो जो भी कामना है उसको धर्म के छतरी के नीचे प्रैक्टिस किया जाए. इसका अर्थ क्या हुआ, कीपिंग द रिलेशनशिप विद इन द फैमिली लाइफ, दैट्स वन, एंड प्लस नॉट सीइंग योर वाइफ एज अ कमोडिटी टू सेटिस्फाई योर जेनिटल्स. सो बेसिकली योर पर्पज ऑफ हैविंग रिलेशनशिप विद हर इज टू एक्चुअली सर्व द सोसाइटी एंड फैमिली एंड द लॉर्ड, नॉट जस्ट टू एक्चुअली सेटिस्फाई योर डिजायर्स ऑफ योर जेनिटल्स. डोंट सी हर एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ माई सेंसेस, सी हर एज एन co-contributor in the ecosystem.
So, but if you are letting go of your semen during married life, does it take away from your mental sharpness?
That's what I said, regulation is required.
Okay. But what would count as regulation?
Discipline. Like, discipline. I would not be able to tell you how many times in a week or how many times in a day. I don't think that's the right answer. But I would say one has to regulate it, because the purpose of life will bring regulation. Desire to regulate will not bring regulation. Have a higher purpose established in mindset.
as long as your ejaculation and the process of sex is fueled by love, it automatically kind of has its own spiritual impact on your existence, that whole process. So sex where it's just for the physical aspect of it, for pleasure, is tamasic, is negative.
Yeah.
But sex within the realms of marriage, within the realms of infinite love that exists within a marriage, it actually makes you closer to your partner and makes both of you spiritually grow.
Absolutely.
And also, there is this concept in yoga of, I don't know what it's called, but it's basically it divides your life into four stages. So your initial stage is where you're learning. That's before the age of 25, where you're preparing for the world. The stage after that is where you're a family householder. Yeah. So in the householder stage, the rules kind of change when it comes to semen, when it comes to spiritual growth. You grow through providing for your family. But if you're under the age of 25,
you just try nofap. You try being away from porn. If you feel that that is benefiting you, then I think you are, you will know what to do.
Yeah, yeah. You, but don't kind of discount things without experiencing it yourself.